What's up? I'm travel photographer Brendan Vanton of brendansadventures.com, and I'm here in Hong Kong. So I've made it to Hong Kong. I'm here on a really short assignment, just 4 days here in Hong Kong. This is a city I absolutely loved the first time I was here, about 2 or 3 years ago. And even though it's a short assignment here, I'm going to do as much exploring as I possibly can. The weather forecast is not great. I'm here in January, and January it tends to be kind of cloudy. Low-hanging clouds tend to stick around the city in January, and so it can be rainy, and I'm going to hope for the best. I'm going to hope for the absolute best. I'm a little bit jet-lagged after arriving, so I'm going to call it a night. Right now, I'm going to get some sleep, and then tomorrow I have a full day to explore with a local guide who's going to show me around some places I've never been before. We're going to go to some places that I have been before. And then I'm off on my own for the rest of the time here in Hong Kong to explore. So, I'm going to get some sleep and hopefully be more conscious tomorrow when we talk again. And yeah, let's go to sleep and then let's go explore Hong Kong for a day. Let's go. So yesterday exploring Hong Kong was pretty fantastic. It was pretty cool. The weather was amazing yesterday, and maybe a little bit of a downside to the weather being amazing yesterday when I wasn't out shooting photos but kind of just exploring is that today the weather is not fantastic. It's just started raining and the forecast is for rain for 2 days or maybe even 3 days, and since I only have 3 days here, that kind of sucks a little bit. But even in the rain, Hong Kong's just such a cool city. Yesterday we got really good food. We went to one of the most affordable Michelin star restaurants in the world to eat dim sum. Then we went to a less affordable but fantastic steakhouse on top of the city. We also went to places like a couple temples, a couple markets. We went over to the Kowloon side. Right now I'm at the Ozo Hotel on the other side on Hong Kong Island.
And we went up to Victoria Peak. We took the tram up there. We did lots of cool stuff yesterday. And I've decided that I've seen a lot of Hong Kong. This is now my second time here. I've photographed a lot of the classic viewpoints. But what most people don't realize about Hong Kong is that there's a ton of nature here. Most people know Hong Kong for the skyscrapers and maybe Victoria Harbor and the viewpoint at Victoria Peak and stuff like that, but they don't realize that this country is bigger than just the city, that there's a lot of national parks, a lot of little lakes and reservoirs. There's mountains to climb, or at least hills to climb. They're like 600-700 meters above sea level, with cool views of both nature and the city. There's also villages, stilt villages, on some of the islands. So I'm going to spend the next 3 days exploring. That's what I do best. But I'm not going to explore classic Hong Kong, or at least I don't think I'm going to. But the weather might change that. I want to go see nature. So I want to go find a stilt village or a fishing village on one of the islands. I want to go out to try to find monkeys. I know that there's monkeys near a reservoir. And I want to climb at least one hill, maybe Kowloon Peak or Lion's Head Peak, to get a wicked view of Hong Kong and the natural landscape around it. So let's hope for the best with this weather. If the weather improves a little bit, or at least stays just cloudy and not pouring rain, we'll go find nature. And if not, we'll find something else to do in the city, because there's so much to do here. And I'm done blabbing, because this has been now 3 minutes of me talking. Let's go explore rather than listen to me blab. So I've made it to the reservoir part of town after short MTR ride. The subway system here in Hong Kong is just unreal. It's so good. It'll get you anywhere quick. And I got to maybe 20 minutes from here, 25 minutes, and then I walked. You can also catch bus 72 to get here. And then you're basically in nature. It's really, really beautiful here. Absolutely stunning. And there's been a ton of monkeys around. They basically follow you around because too many people feed them. Do not feed the monkeys. They're wild. Don't feed wild monkeys. That's bad. But on the positive side of that, they've been pretty easy to photograph so far. So where I am behind me, you probably can't see it anymore, but that's Kowloon Reservoir. And so that's the place you wanna get to. And then if you keep walking along here, along the road, there's like four or five other hiking trails, even more than that maybe. And I'm going to one called Shek Lui Pui or something like that, which has a loop trail around it. So I'm gonna hike around there, take some pictures, and then maybe try to find a spot to do some landscape photography if the weather holds off. So far it's holding off, but it looks like it's gonna come down pretty soon. So let's keep exploring. So I'm done here at the reservoir. Absolutely beautiful out here. It's just stunning. And it's a really interesting place because you're really not that far from Hong Kong. And there's a couple places along the way that you actually see the skyline of Hong Kong in the distance, which is crazy because you've got this really, really green place. And then you've got the urban sprawl and you know, just the concrete jungle of Hong Kong behind it. So it's a really cool place out here. And It's a decent place for landscape photography, but the weather isn't. The weather's like overcast and there's no detail in the sky because it's overcast. Ideally, with landscapes, you want a little bit more break in the clouds when you're out here. So even though it's not great weather for landscape photography, it's fantastic for monkeyography, for monkey photography. When you get overcast clouds like this, it really works well with wildlife photography because the sky works like a natural softbox for the animals, as long as you don't have the sky in your photo as well. So I'm gonna go do some more monkeyography here. And then with these low-hanging clouds and a potential rainstorm, I'm gonna go photograph the skyline from Victoria Harbor on the Kowloon side in hopes that I get these really low-hanging clouds and maybe a mix of, the clouds hanging right into the buildings or something like that. So I'm gonna head that way now and maybe do some more monkeyography on the way there. Okay, so I've come here to Tai O, and as you can see, it's cloudy and it's rainy. It's kind of like a misty rain that's really low hanging. And Tai O is behind me, as I might as well just forget that umbrella word. Yeah, so Tai O is behind me, and it's a still village here in Hong Kong. Again, it's one of those examples that Hong Kong isn't just about the big city and skyscrapers here. It's more than that. There's mountains, there's nature, there's a lot of really beautiful things here. As I fight with my umbrella, look at that. That was talent right there. You didn't see it, but it was talent. And Hong Kong is just absolutely diverse in what it has to offer. You have the city, you have the skyscrapers, and then you have villages like this. You have mountains like those behind me on the other side that are all covered in fog and absolutely beautiful right now. You have culture, you have temples. You really have a lot more than just the skyscrapers and the skyline, which is really cool. So it's raining, and the reason I came here today is because it's a place that I can get some shots even if it's raining, I think. So I'm gonna explore a little bit in Tai O in the Stilt Village today as it rains and the wind blows, and I might shoot some photos that way towards the other village because there's some mist hanging on the clouds that looks amazing right now. And then maybe I'll shoot some seascapes if the weather eases up a little bit. Seascapes are easy to shoot in the rain, as if the rain's kind of going straight down, but if it's blowing sideways like it is right now, it's almost impossible. So let's do some exploring, and then let's see if we can photograph something this evening. We'll be right back.
So since it was really rainy and wet down at the bottom in town, and I wasn't really thinking I was going to be able to get the shots I was hoping to get around sunset, I looked around and I saw this mountain and I thought, I wonder if I can climb that thing. And it turns out I can climb this thing. And I'm way up above Tai O, which is down there. The trail was just this tiny little trail. I'm not even sure it was an official trail. But it was really, really challenging, to be honest, especially because it's wet and rainy and, you know, a little bit crazy. So I was scrambling a little bit. And yeah, I'm up here now. It's windy, it's rainy, and it's also amazing. It is so cool up here. And again, I'm always blown away by the fact that this is Hong Kong. Everybody sees Hong Kong as this urban jungle. And you've got regular jungle here and regular forest. And actually this part, this mountain here, actually kind of looks like Iceland. It doesn't look like Hong Kong. It doesn't even look like China. Down in the village, it feels more like a Vietnamese or Indonesian village than it does Hong Kong, which is really cool. And I love that you have that variety here in Hong Kong. So I'm gonna hang out here and hope the rain doesn't batter me more. It looks like there's a lot more coming. I'm gonna hope that the fog doesn't get too messy down there and I can get some shots of both Tai O and the landscape around it, the island itself. Hopefully the weather holds off long enough for me to do that and it doesn't get completely cloudy and foggy up here. And then hopefully I can get back down at the end of the day. Tomorrow they're predicting rain again. So in the morning I'll probably just take it easy and then I might do some exploring through the city, the actual city of Hong Kong tomorrow. And then the hope is that I can climb a mountain just outside of Hong Kong called Kowloon Peak or maybe Lion's Head Peak, one of the two, to get photos of Hong Kong from a completely different perspective than is the norm. So let's hang out here, wait for the sunlight, or I guess the sun's already gone, the light to come down and hopefully get a couple cool shots of Tai O. Let's go. So if yesterday's muddy, slippery rock climbing over there in Tai O wasn't enough, today I've decided to once again climb another peak. I'm at the base of Lion Head Peak, which is like the prevailing mountain above Hong Kong and definitely the most impressive mountain you have above Hong Kong. To get there, it's a bit of a hike for sure. I left from one of the MTR stations downtown and it's just a steep, steep, steep incline through the city. The outskirts of the city to get here. And then you're here in the forest. Again, you're in nature. Really just, I've got skyscrapers right there. And you're right on the edge of the city in beautiful nature in the mountains. There's lots of birds. There's some monkeys here as well. And it's absolutely beautiful. There's a lot of cloud on top of the mountain. In fact, it's completely hidden right now. So I don't know how it's gonna be. It might be a terrible decision for me to go up there today when it's completely covered in cloud, but I kind of have a sneaking suspicion that it's gonna clear up a bit up there. Over Hong Kong Island, it's a bit clear and the sky looks kind of cool, so I'm really hoping this weather pushes over the mountains and I get some really cool views of Hong Kong in the blue hour, sunset hour, and maybe even a bit into the night. So let's push up this hill and continue up to Lion Peak. Let's do it. So I don't know if I have horseshoes up my ass or what, but I got up here and it's clear. You can see the clouds have kind of moved a little bit back there. So where the hike starts from is way down there in the bottom, and then it goes way up through these hills into those clouds and then follows a ledge around the back and then up here. This isn't Lion's Head right here. Lion's Head is that little peak right there. So I don't know what this is called. This is one of the peaks next to it. The views are ridiculous. And if somehow that cloud doesn't come here and encroach my view, sunset up here tonight is gonna be out of this world. So one problem I'm having is that I'm up here way too early. So it's only 3 p.m. I read some advice saying it was a 2-hour hike to get up here. It took me an hour, and I don't really think I was moving that fast. So hopefully the clouds stay away. They're coming and going. If you look over there, you can see how quick they're moving. Within 2 minutes, they could be back. So I'm going to need a lot of luck for there to be no clouds right at sunset. But right now, it's absolutely beautiful. I can see the harbor over there with all the boats. You can see Hong Kong Island way off in the distance. This is the old airport in the middle there, which was one of the most dangerous airports in the world. It's now a cruise ship port or a ship port of some sort, I believe. And then you have Kowloon over here. It is unbelievable. And the drop right here, although you probably can't tell on the wide angle, is pretty imposing. It's fantastic up here. So I'm gonna stay up here. I'm gonna shoot photos until I drop or fill my memory card or the weather turns completely bad on me.
So guys, that's it from Hong Kong. I had an absolutely brilliant time in the city despite the bad weather I had the whole time I was there. That was now my second time in Hong Kong. The first time I really focused on, you know, the classic things to do in Hong Kong, visiting Victoria Peak and the Buddha and, you know, downtown and stuff like that. This time I really wanted to focus on finding nature. One of the things that people misconstrue about Hong Kong all the time is they think it's a country that's just a city, when in reality it's the city, but then there's also a lot of different villages, a lot of islands, and a lot of nature. Now, I wasn't obviously able to get to all that nature in one episode. There's dozens and dozens of islands that you can visit via ferries, and there's a lot of different parts of the city, both on the mainland side of Hong Kong and the islands that are nature oriented. So if you're into nature, you can't just see all of Hong Kong in a couple days. You really need a week or 2 weeks, or I'm sure people that have spent a month in Hong Kong haven't seen everything that it has to offer. It is more than just the city. Anyways, guys, that's it for this episode. I've got a lot more coming up on the channel. As you can probably imagine, it's never ending. On this travel photography channel and in my travel life, I'm constantly on the go. Upcoming episodes are coming from places like Venice. We got an episode from Venice, got an episode from somewhere else, got an episode from Cinque Terre coming, Cinque Terre, Italy, which is stunning. And then I'm off to Turkey next. So there's going to be a lot of adventure coming up on the channel. I hope you stay tuned and stay subscribed. I'll catch you next time. Peace.